So we'll begin with the Sadachar aspect. Sadachar basically means good behavior, proper practice, which reflects in a person's character. So when one sees live examples of the principles of the scripture, it helps build faith in the process. When devotees see each other free of duplicity, practicing what they preach, it creates an environment of trust in each other. So, in the Chaitanya Charitamrita, the author, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, he is setting a great example of Sadachar. As he is writing the Chaitanya Charitamrita, he is expressing in great detail what is his motivation to write this Chaitanya Charitamrita. Ore mudha lokashuna chaitanya mangal chaitanya mahima jate janibe sakal Krishna lila bhagavate kohe vedavyas chaitanya lilaravyasa vrindavana das Vrindavana Dasa Koila Chaitanya Mangal Yahara Shravana Nashe Sarva Amangal. So someone may doubt that if Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes have already been described by Vrindavan Das Thakur in Sri Chaitanya Bhagavat, which is also known as Chaitanya Mangal, why does Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami have to write one more literature on Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? What is his motivation? What is his intention? Does he want to supersede Vrindavan Das Thakur? Does he want to really show that he can create a very unique piece of literature? So all these questions may arise. So therefore, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami, although very, very exalted, pure, still he is going out of his way to explain the intention behind his writing of Chaitanya Charitamrita, where he says that, you know, Chaitanya Bhagavat is perfectly pure, very advanced. It purifies all the souls. The Chaitanya Bhagavat in every possible way. Chaitanya Nitaira Yate Janiye Mahima Yate Jani Krishna Bhakti Siddhantira Sima. It contains the summit of Krishna Bhakti Siddhanta. Everything is there. Bhagavata Yate Bhakti Siddhantira Sar Likhyachen Ihajani Korya Udhar. The conclusions of Siddhanta in the Srimad Bhagavatam, that is contained in Chaitanya Bhagavat. What are the Siddhantas of Srimad Bhagavat? Bhakti Tattva, Prema Tattva, Krishna Tattva, Bhakti Tattva, Prema Tattva Sar, Bhava Tattva, Rasa Tattva, Lila Tattva are. So all these six Tattvas of Krishna, Bhakti, Prema, Bhava, Rasa, Lila, which is there in the various pastimes of Bhagavatam, all of that is there in Chaitanya Bhagavat. He accepts that, he acknowledges that, and says, Chaitanya Mangala Shune Yadi Pashandi Yavan Seha Maha Vaishnava Hoye Tatakshan. Anyone who hears Chaitanya Mangala, even if he is from a very, very low class background, he becomes devotee instantly. And then he says, Manushya rachite nare aiche granta dhanya Vrindavana dasamukhe vakta sri chaitanya. That this Chaitanya Mangal has been actually written by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and Vrindavan Das Thakur was simply an instrument. So then one suspicion grows further. If the previous literature, the previous work written by Vrindavan Das Thakur is so flawless, so pure, so perfect, what is the need for Kaviraj Goswami to write another set of literatures called Chaitanya Charitamrita. So this is a very important point, because even if there is some doubt about the intention behind the service of a Vaishnava, that question mark, it impedes our ability to put faith in that person. And therefore, Kaviraj Goswami is sensitive to the fact that if my hearers and readers in future for some reason start doubting my character, my sadachar, my acharan, my dealings, my behavior, they may not take the message of the Chaitanya Charitamrita very seriously. And therefore it is important for me to elaborate the history behind why the Chaitanya Charitamrita was written. So he says that actually Vrindavan Das Thakur is the Vyasa of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's Leela. And he says, Ata eva bhajaloke Chaitanya Nityananda Khandive Samsara Dukkha Pabe Premananda. You worship Gaur Nithai, you will be free from distress, you will experience prema. Then he says that Chaitanya Chandrera Lila Ananta Apar Varnite Varnite Granta Huila Vistar. He says that actually when Vrindavan Das Thakur was writing the Chaitanya Bhagavat, or it was known as Chaitanya Mangal at that time, as he continued writing, because Mahaprabhu's qualities and pastimes are unlimited, because of that, Chaitanya Chandrera Lila Ananta Apar Varnite Varnite, as he was describing, Grantha Hoila Vistar, the Grantha became very expanded. And therefore, Nityananda Lila Varnane Hoila Avesh, Chaitanyara Shesh Lila Rahila Avashesh. So, for some reason, Vrindavan Das Thakur, he became very absorbed in glorifying Lord Nityananda's pastimes. And therefore, Mahaprabhu's remaining pastimes were remaining. They could not be elaborately described. So, Vrindavan Das Thakur could only cover Mahaprabhu's pastimes till sannyas. And Mahaprabhu's post-sannyas pastimes, he could not do justice. And so he says that actually, Saisava Lilara Shuniti Vivaran Vrindavana Vasi Bhaktir Utkantitaman. The devotees in Sri Vrindavan Dham, the Gaudiyas who had settled in Sri Vrindavan next to Radhakund and other places, after the disappearance of the Goswamis, the pangs of separation from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was experienced more and more. Chaitanya Lila Ratna Sar Swarupera Bhandar Teuthuila Raghunathera Kanthe Taha Kichu Yeshunilu Taha Iha Vistarilu Bhaktagana Dilu Ei Bhete. So Kaviraj Goswami says Mahaprabhu's pastimes are like a mine of jewels. They were held by Swarup Damodar Goswami in his treasure chest. Das Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, picked those jewels and placed it in his throat. And then when he spoke Mahaprabhu's pastimes on the bank of Radhakund, I was fortunate to hear those pastimes. And therefore, whatever I have heard from Das Goswami, Taha kichu yeshinulu taha iha vistarilu bhaktagana dilu ei bhete, I am simply offering this as a gift to the Vaishnava community. And therefore he says that on the order and the instructions of these devotees, I actually began contemplating writing the Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. So he's giving this explanation. He is clarifying his position, his situation. Because when devotees are practicing Krishna consciousness, there may be episodes where the environment of trust may be severely compromised. And therefore, we need an environment of trust. So, community's expansion is unsustainable without Vaishnav Sadachar. So, someone can read this. Right. So, Srila Prabhupada specifically wanted the devotees to actually understand what is the substance of Vaishnava behavior from the books. And if you see in the third canto of Bhagavatam, Lord Kapila says, to Mother Devahuti, Titikshava Karunika Suhurda Sarvadehinam Ajata Shatra Shanta Sadhavo Sadhu Bhushanam. That there are certain qualities of a devotee which includes Titikshava, tolerance, Karunika, compassion, Suhurda Sarvadehinam, friend of all, Ajata Shatra, who is not inimical towards others. So the last word says sadhu bhushanam. So bhushanam basically means medals of victory. Basically, when a soldier is fighting hard against the enemy forces, and when that soldier's efforts are recognized by the army and the government decorates that soldier with medals of victory. These medals are not forcibly gathered by the soldier on demand. He has only control over actually demonstrating and displaying true bravery. And if the government is impressed, then they give him medals. So therefore, by sincere practice of Krishna consciousness, gradually, Krishna becomes pleased with the devotee's effort in his fight against Maya. When Krishna is impressed with the Krishna conscious soldier, then Krishna, being the supreme government, decides to decorate such devotees with medals of victory. And these medals come in various flavors: tolerance, compassion, friend to all, being free from inimical tendencies. These are all divine qualities bestowed by Krishna. It cannot be forcibly snatched. So it is a reciprocation by Krishna for the sincere practice of Krishna consciousness. So therefore, Prabhupada here mentions, just like boiling the milk, it becomes thicker and sweeter. Boil the milk. What does it mean? Go into the process deeply. Study the books of Srila Prabhupada carefully. Understand what Srila Prabhupada means by looking at the philosophy from different angles. Bhagavatam says, Shrinavata Shraddhaya Nityam Grinatascha Svacheshtitam Kale Nanati Dirghena Bhagavan Vishate Hridi. When one studies the Srimad Bhagavatam regularly, with faith, with attention, Kale Nanati Dirghena, in very short time, Svacheshtitam, putting his efforts, Krishna reveals the intelligence from within. So therefore, we have to ignite our spiritual intelligence, and that ignition of the spiritual intelligence happens when Krishna is pleased. And Krishna is pleased with a sincere practice of bhakti. So therefore, when we say boil the milk, it means study the process, understand the process carefully. I was distributing books in the local trains in Mumbai. I showed this Bhagavad Gita to one gentleman, and he looked at the Gita. He was asking me all kinds of questions for 20 minutes. And then after asking so many questions, finally he says, actually my father has already purchased one Gita. And my grandfather had purchased one more Gita. I have one in English, one in Marathi. I already have two. So I was thinking, you could have told me 20 minutes ago. So anyway, I didn't respond. I just smiled at him, gave him temple card, gave him some prasad and said, okay, anyway, if you want to attend any courses to know the Gita more, please come. And then I went to the next bogey. The guy chased me to the next bogey, came to me and said, I want Gita. So I said, why you want? You already have two. He says, no, I want Gita from you. I said, why? He says, last 6 months, my boss has been angry at me, chastising me. My wife has been chastising me. My friends have been chastising me. You are the first person in 6 months who smiled at me. I want Gita from you. So I was thinking, if I knew, I would have laughed and given whole Bhagavatam set. So nowadays in Kali Yuga, people go through so many mood swings. To remain depressed and to appear depressed seems to be the normal trend. So one of my devotee friends is a very nice devotee. He has got a happy disposition. So he's always smiling all the time. So his boss called him inside the cabin and said, anything wrong with you? He said, hey, what happened? You're always smiling. So that has become now the standard in Kali Yuga, that if someone smiles, people think he's crazy. So therefore, the practice of Krishna consciousness is not just to make outsiders happy. It is for those who are practicing process to actually understand how this process can be thicker and sweeter. Then Prabhupada explains, leadership means setting an example. Masses need an example to follow. Yadyad acharati sreshtas tat tat eve tarojana. Sayat pramanam kurute lokas tat anuvartate. Whatever action great man performs, common men follow. Whatever standards he set by exemplary acts, all the world pursues. Purport. People in general require a leader who can teach the public by practical behavior. So, you always need somebody to lead and show the way. And so that's what Srila Prabhupada is referring to here. And practically, all of us have this experience that people follow other souls. Yadyat acharati sreshthas. Whatever great souls will do, people follow. One time, His Holiness Radhanath Maharaj was on a flight to Belgaum. So in the course of that flight, he saw that his servant suddenly was looking very blissful, smiling and laughing and everything. So he asked him, you look more happy than usual. What is the matter? And so the servant said, the Indian cricket team is on the same flight. So he was in ecstasy. Because you have 330 million demigods, but these 11 are extra special. So they have active devotees. So then, you know, the flight landed in Belgaum and the devotees had come to receive Maharaj. So the cricket team came out thinking that the reception is for them. So, and then they found that none of the garlands were coming to them. And then they were waiting and one of the cricket players, he approached Maharaj and said, "Let me pick your luggage and let me serve you." And he was telling him that, "I also have desire to practice spirituality, to do satsang, but I never get time, I'm so busy. Please give me blessings, you know, that I can actually get some time to practice more." Maharaj said, "Don't worry, I bless you." And within 1 year, that cricketer got banned from cricket. He got unlimited time. So be careful while asking blessings. But the fact is, these are the leaders today. The film stars, the politicians, the, you know, cricket players and all these football players. The whole world is mad after football. So Prabhupada is saying here, people generally require a leader who can teach the public by practical behavior. And so we find the safeguarding the image of the mission. Someone read this. Right. So we have to understand that we are representing the mission of ISKCON. I was just sharing the story that during Prabhupada's presence in India in the 70s, ISKCON was very much accused of being CIA agents. And nobody would have imagined that the government would support ISKCON activities, considering what happened in those days. And there were all these films and movies about Dam Maro Dam and everything, branding ISKCON in a very negative light. So, in the 80s, you know, there was one Sankirtan van in Canada which was going on the highways. And this Sankirtan van was being driven by one young Canadian brahmachari in saffron. And his van was filled with Bhagavad Gitas. So as he was driving, he found that there were two elderly Indian gentlemen on the road, stranded, their car had broken down. So they were asking for lift. This Sankirtan devotee could have driven past, but for some reason he stopped and he felt that I must help them, and then got both of them on his van. And he offered them breakfast, prasadam. And then they started asking him, "What is your van filled with?" And he said, "Sankirtan books, these are Bhagavad Gitas, I've dedicated my life." And they were very impressed. "Oh, you are a Canadian young boy, you're dedicating your life for distributing Gita. Even in India, young people don't do that." So then, what happened was that, fast forward to 90s, these two old men who were on stranded on the roads and given a lift by ISKCON devotee, they left with excellent image about ISKCON. That ISKCON devotees are dedicated, ISKCON devotees are helpful, they are friendly, they are willing to, you know, reach out to people in distress. So it was very positive image. So 1996-97, ISKCON Delhi temple was going to be opened. So that time, one of the Delhi devotees was in charge of the public relations. He went to meet Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who was going to be, you know, going into the elections that time. And there were predictions that he may win. So when he went to visit this Atal Bihari Vajpayee, who was the BJP leader and the incumbent prime minister on behalf of BJP, he shared this story that Atal Bihari Vajpayee and Shivraj Patil, these were the two people who were on the road. And they were given lift by this Canadian Brahmachari and they were super impressed. And so Atal Bihari Vajpayee said, I can see that ISKCON is doing very genuine work. And I want to really support. And so this devotee said, we want you to come and inaugurate the temple. But he said, you don't even know whether I will be prime minister or not. Elections are not yet over. So why are you inviting me? If I don't become prime minister, so what? The devotee said, whether you become prime minister or not, we want you only. And then the devotee was praying intensely that he actually becomes. All the devotees don't do gambling, but they do, they take calculated risks. So then he actually won the election, became the prime minister, and then he came to the ISKCON temple in Delhi, and the transcript of that speech you should try to read if you get an opportunity. It's a classic lecture which he gave, glorifying Prabhupada, glorifying ISKCON. And then in 1977, when Srila Prabhupada left, Srila Prabhupada himself could not get the satisfaction of having ISKCON accepted in the topmost government circles in India. But it took 20 years when an ISKCON temple was finally inaugurated by the highest government office in India, the Prime Minister. And then a couple of months later, the Bangalore ISKCON was inaugurated by the president. So therefore, once the mission has a certain image, it takes a long time to transform that image. It's not so easy. And you can see an ordinary, regular Sankirtan Brahmachari on the roads, he could make an impact. So we never know who is observing and who is judging our movement through whose behavior. And therefore, this is a very interesting story which I wanted to share with you. And as part of Sadachar, we have the example of Roma Harshana, who was sitting and giving Bhagavatam, and when Balramji entered, he did not offer respects. So Balramji said that you are not offering respects, you are teaching about how to respect and how to worship, but you yourself are not following. And therefore Balramji took a piece of straw and killed Roma Harshan on the spot. And therefore, Adantasya Avinitasya Vratha Pandita Manina Na Bhavaya Gunantisma. If you are teaching big, big things, but you are not able to practice that. So Balramji became extremely heavy with Roma Harshana and he killed him. So therefore, when we are preaching Krishna consciousness, people are wanting to see whether we are trying to practice that also. So if you are teaching tolerance, if you are teaching humility, if you are teaching this, so many things, then our character will be also closely examined. And therefore, it's very important for devotees to study all of these incidents very carefully. And another example is of Sanatan Goswami. As Sanatan Goswami was passing through the forest, Sanatan Goswami contracted a certain kind of skin disease and Mahaprabhu wanted to embrace him. So Mahaprabhu was extremely impressed with Rupa and Sanatan mainly because of their humility. Their humility and their tolerance attracted Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And therefore, Mahaprabhu was extremely impressed with them and gave his full powers to Sanatan Goswami and Rupa Goswami. They were so tolerant and so humble, they captured Mahaprabhu's heart. So Srila Prabhupada, when he was in Mumbai, one of his servants brought some kachoris to offer to Srila Prabhupada. So Srila Prabhupada tasted some of those kachoris and Prabhupada said, "Please keep some of these kachoris for tomorrow. I will taste it tomorrow." So the servant brought those kachoris into the kitchen and there was a lady in the kitchen and he gave those kachoris to the lady and said, "I'm keeping these kachoris here in the kitchen. Tomorrow Prabhupada will taste it." She said, "Aray, you can't keep the kachori in the kitchen. Anybody will come and take and I can't take responsibility." He said, "No, no, you must take. And there was this whole altercation between them. He left, kept keeping the kachoris there. Next day he came, kachoris were not there. So he said, "I told you, you should keep the kachoris." She said, "I told you not to keep it here." And the typical blame game began. So he said, "Now what will I tell Prabhupada? He's asking for the kachoris." And she was busy cooking. She said, "Just tell Prabhupada that, you know, kachoris were in the kitchen and cat came and cat ate it. Some cat must have eaten. So many cats come." So he went up, came down. She was still cooking. She said, "So what did Prabhupada say?" And the servant said, "Prabhupada said, whoever says cat has eaten, they have eaten." So she felt very offended. How can Prabhupada say like this? I have dedicated my life to ISKCON. This is a question mark on my integrity. My intentions are being questioned. I cannot continue serving like this. So therefore, this is a big challenge that as we are serving, some incidents will happen. And when those incidents happen, immediately the false ego rears up and we start thinking, "I am like this, I am like that." So then she thought, anyway, the most important thing is Prabhupada wants the kachori. So let me organize that. So she went to another kitchen nearby, made some fresh kachoris, gave it to Prabhupada. Prabhupada had 5 or 6 of them. And so, when we are engaged in performing service, unless we have sufficient tolerance and humility, we cannot maintain enthusiasm. Because certain incidents will happen which will dampen our enthusiasm to continue serving. पतित पावन हेतु तोमार अवतार आमाबाई जगते पतित नहियार. So Sanatan Goswami is telling Mahaprabhu, "You are patita pavan and I am the most patita." And he's saying that, "My dear Lord, if you compare to Jagai and Madhai, Jagai Madhai dui korile udhar, tara udharile shrama nahika tomar." You did not have much effort to expend while delivering Jagai and Madhai. Why? Brahmana jati tara navadvipe ghar, niche seva nahi kara nahi niche rakur par. Jagai and Madhai were better than us because they were born in Brahman families, they were born in holy dham, Navadvip, and thirdly, they did not serve these kind of low class people the way we served. And therefore, they are more advanced than us. They had only one fault. Sabe eka dosha tara hoye papachar, paparashida hinama bhase tomar. What was their fault? They were only sinful. They were engaged in sins. But that sins was purified by chanting your names. And therefore, tomar nama laya tomar korila nindan, tara nama hoila tara muktira karan. That same holy name became the cause of their deliverance. And hence, Rupa and Sanatan Goswami, who was the finance minister and prime minister, they conclude जगाए मधाए होइते कोटि कोटि गुण, अधम पतित प्रभु आमि दुइजन। कंपेयर टू जगाए एंड मधाए, वी आर मोर फॉलन एंड वी आर मोर सब्जेक्टेड टू सिंफुल रिएक्शंस, बिकॉज वी हैव इंडल्ज्ड इन म्लेच्छ जाति म्लेच्छ सेवी करि म्लेच्छ कर्म, गो ब्राह्मण द्रोहे हिंसे अमार संगम। We have associated with the sinful people. We have facilitated massive degree of sin by facilitating the nefarious activities of Nawab Hussain Shah. And so when Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu hears their plea of humility, Mahaprabhu says, Aji hoite duhar naam rupa sanatan, dainya chhad tomar dainye phate moraman. That I hereby give you the name Rupa and Sanatan, initiate you, and my first instruction to you after initiation, give up your humility. Because your humility is so deep, it is breaking my heart. So this was the quality of disciple of Sanatan Goswami, like of Mahaprabhu, like Sanatan Goswami, where Mahaprabhu had to tell him, give up your humility. In our case, our gurus have to tell us, become humble. Right? Become humble. Start practicing humility. So therefore, this is another example of excellent Sadachar, Rupa and Sanatan. So, what are the considerations of time, place and circumstance in application of Vaishnava Sadachar? First, the sentiments of the people should not be hurt. Because different places have different kinds of situations. And accordingly, the people may be affected in different ways. So the sentiments of the people should not be hurt. Secondly, like, you know, I was just sharing this story in Santon the other day, that Prabhupada was in Amritsar. And there was a whole group of sadhus and they were all speaking Mayavad philosophy. And Prabhupada was supposed to be the next speaker. Prabhupada suddenly got up, started walking away. So Gurudas Prabhu was there with Prabhupada. He stopped Prabhupada and said, Prabhupada, where are you going? Your turn is next. Prabhupada said, I'm not inspired to speak. They're all speaking, everything is one and all. So he said, but Prabhupada, if you leave, your next turn, who will speak? Prabhupada said, you speak. But he said, I am so young. How can I speak? They are all old people, experienced Mayavadis. Prabhupada said, the level at which they are speaking, whatever you know is enough. And Prabhupada went. And so, Gurudas Prabhu got the mic and he said, you are saying everything is one, everything was one. Is the stool on the street same as Rasgulla the sweet? So there was a gasp of shock from the audience. And they all came to Prabhupada to complain. And some of these old sadhus were saying, your disciple is offending us, he is telling us to eat stool on the street. Prabhupada looked at Gurudas, did you tell that? He says, no, I was only giving example, trying to refute impersonalism, that stool on the street and rasgulla sweet both cannot be same, that's all. Prabhupada turned to these sadhus and said, you know, my American disciples, they give very graphic examples. But I'll take care of that, don't worry. And Prabhupada, you know, asked them to go. And when they left, Prabhupada turned to Gurudas Prabhu and said, what was that example? Rasgulla the sweet and stool on the street. Excellent example. And Prabhupada mentioned that, you know, the example is good, but you should also be very careful in what context we share it, because not everything can be understood by everyone, everywhere, every time. So therefore, when Bhishma Dev was on the bed of arrows and Pandavas along with the various sages entered, at that time, Tan Sametan Mahabhaga Upalabhya Vasuttama Pujayan Asa Dharmagyo Desha Kala Vibhagavit. When Bhishma Dev saw, he knew he has to offer welcome and respect, but he could not get up. So how could he offer respect and welcome when every part of his body is pierced by an arrow? So he realized, in this situation, only one part of my body is functioning, which is my tongue. So desha kala vibhagavit, as per time, place, circumstance, he offered words of worship and welcome. So he adjusted the principles as per time, place and circumstance. So therefore, packaging the message appropriately while maintaining the spirit of parampara. Okay, so you know the parampara has been going on since long time, but can the message be understood today by people? So that's a very crucial element. And so packaging of the message is very important. And so when you read Prabhupada's purports, the way he writes, unalloyed devotional service. These are all terms you don't usually find, you know, before Prabhupada's specific contributions. Sense gratification. It's a very unique term. I don't think anyone had heard that term before. We had only done it, but we did not read about it or hear about it. Sense gratification. Sense objects. So, you know, Srila Prabhupada was very expert in packaging the message while maintaining the spirit of the parampara. And capable management means improvising without compromising. Improvising without compromising, which means that as per situation, whatever is required, we try to do, but we do not compromise as far as our principles are concerned. Like that. And purity and not the packaging is our core preaching strategy. Purity is the force, and unless the purity is there, just having packaging is not going to help. So there was a doctor's conference in Russia, and one doctor came out of the conference and he found a book table, and there was this young brahmachari standing there on the book table selling books. So the doctor looked at the brahmachari and said, "Hey, these books are for whom?" And the brahmachari looked with great confidence in the eyes of this doctor and said, "These books are for you, to help you understand the difference between what you are and what you are not." So he got bewildered. Hey, my God, such a young fellow, so much confidence. He looked at him and said, "Hey, what is your age?" So the brahmachari said, "Whose age, body or souls?" So one thing ISKCON does is gives you a lot of self-confidence and gives you the strength to answer any kind of question. So he said, "Well, what is the difference? Tell me." So he says, "My body is only 22 years old, soul is eternal." So this doctor was very impressed. He purchased the book, got connected, and now he's an initiated devotee in Russia. You know, so he saw that, okay, here this person is young, but he has the conviction. And therefore, sometimes that conviction is transmitted in our interactions with others as we are practicing the process and sharing this process with others. And so when Prabhupada first came to America, so many young people got connected. Why? They were affected by Prabhupada's purity. They were affected by Srila Prabhupada's purity. They could see that here is someone who is genuinely presenting a philosophy and genuinely cares for us. So Brahmanand Prabhu came and joined Prabhupada, so his mother got a little worried. So she sent the other brother to get Brahmanand Prabhu back. And his other brother, who got impressed with Prabhupada, he also joined. So both the brothers joined. And so their mother came to talk to Prabhupada. She met Prabhupada and said, You have taken both my sons away. This is not good. And Prabhupada said, what? They did not have a place to stay. I gave them a place. They didn't have clothes to wear. I gave them nice clothes. They didn't have food to eat. I am cooking for them, feeding them. For all I am doing for them, you should give me a donation. So she got bewildered. And she looked at Prabhupada and said, but I have already donated my 2 cents. Prabhupada said, thank you very much. So Srila Prabhupada established an international society and organized this society with the help of school and college dropouts at that time. And it's practically impossible for anyone to imagine. How is it possible? So therefore, you know, at any point, what is important is the process itself works, and we have to have faith in the process. One of our brahmacharis joined, and his father came to argue with the president. And he started saying, this is not the age for him to join. When he is my age, he should join and he should practice. What is this? So the president said, okay, let the son go, you join. He got bewildered. He said, well, I have to go and ask my family. So next day he came and said, let my son stay, no problem. So it's very easy to say, we will follow when the right time comes and all, but the right time never comes. So whatever time we feel inspired by, at that moment, our connection to Krishna should begin. And therefore, with respect to Vaishnav Sadachar, Prabhupada established Harinam Sankirtan in the streets in America very solidly, which was successful. When Prabhupada came to India, Prabhupada said, stop this Harinam Sankirtan on the streets. Because in India, when you chant on the streets, people may think you are beggars and throw a few paise. So ISKCON will be known as beggars movement in India. Stop the Harinam Sankirtan. That will not work. So instead, Prabhupada started life membership program. And Prabhupada said, go to prominent people's homes. Indians like to feed others. So they'll invite you, feed you, and then we'll make them members and charge them also. So Prabhupada said, in hotel when you eat, you spend money. Here when we eat, we earn money. So Prabhupada was in somebody's house in Calcutta, and this person was forcing them. All the devotees were sitting. Prabhupada was there. He said, please eat more, please eat more. You know, regular Indian hospitality. Take more, take more. And the American people, they didn't know whether to say no or yes or what. They kept on eating. When they went back to their temple in Albert Road, one brahmachari held his hand on the stomach and said, Prabhupada, my stomach is aching. Prabhupada said, yes, you had 25 puris. So he got shocked. He said, Prabhupada, how do you know? Prabhupada said, I was counting. And another brahmachari started laughing loudly. Prabhupada said, you don't laugh. You had 15. And then Prabhupada said, this life membership program we have begun, we will have invitations 5-10 houses every day. You can't be eating everywhere. We have to go there, honor a little bit, but we are mainly there to connect them to our society and make them members. So, one particular aspect worked in the West, another aspect worked in India. So not everything will work everywhere. So therefore, Prabhupada was quite expert in improvising without compromising. So therefore, we have also created, you know, a manual on Vaishnav etiquette and lifestyle at Chopati. And I think it's available on the Desire Tree. Probably this is an old presentation. By now there may be few more versions available on various basic things and aspects like that. So we now go to the Sambandha aspect, which is relationships. And we find that there is an inherent need of the individuals. There are different needs of the individuals which we will go through One of the needs is appreciation. So appreciation basically means either reward for seva, acknowledgement of one's activity, appreciating the sacrifices made, recognition for one's contribution. Right? And these are very important, crucial reciprocations which people are always expecting. So, although we perform service which is ahoituki apratihata yayatma supersedati, but still, as part of our Vaishnava culture, it is always good to appreciate. Krishna pada padma gandha yajana pai, brahma loka adisukha tarinai bhai, Sri Chaitanya Nityananda Charane Chintiya Pathachadi Yai Pathe Yayena Dhaya Grame Grame Pathachadi Yai Vane Vane Kai Mane Vakye Kore Chaitanya Charane Bhakshana Apekshanahi Kshudha Divastagaman Shudhanahi Badhe Chaitanya Charane Praptimun. So when Das Goswami is in front of Lord Nityananda, Lord Nityananda Prabhu is glorifying him, acknowledging him and saying he is so detached because he has experienced the fragrance of Krishna's lotus feet. And because of this, he does not consider any kind of material comfort in his own life. Bhakshana apeksha nahi, samasta divas gaman, kshudha nahi badhe, chaitanya charana praptye man. His mind is so focused on Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lotus feet. He is not concerned with hunger or thirst or anything. So not everybody can be on the level of Raghunath Das Goswami to be totally focused, absorbed in the Lord's lotus feet every moment. And therefore, we have certain human needs. And therefore, the whole idea of devotee care of a community is we have to support devotees in their journey from womb to tomb, which means that at every stage, whatever physical, emotional, social and spiritual needs are there of the devotees, that should be fulfilled within the community of devotees. So therefore, you know, to be acknowledged and appreciated and recognized may be a human need. But a devotee should not be in a situation where he sacrifices in the Vaishnava satsang and then he has to wait for appreciation in some other forum. And therefore, if those things are taken care of here, that is very powerful in giving a feeling of reciprocation for such a devotee. So in Chaupati, during our whole course of rolling out our devotee care program, we had one simple formula, which was a happy devotee stays. A dissatisfied, disgruntled devotee leaves. So therefore, only spiritual needs are taken care, but other needs are not taken care, the person may not survive. He may just leave. And therefore, we have to consider from every angle what can be done to keep the devotee satisfied. So, Prabhupada was in Amsterdam and they were installing the deities and they were all very young people and they were not experienced in how installation should happen. So Prabhupada was in a very angry mood because he saw nothing was in order. Prabhupada asked, where is the fruits for the yajna? They said, we have used in fruit salad. And Prabhupada asked something else that was also not there. It was all blunder. And Prabhupada was chastising, shouting. And then suddenly he heard loud sounds from inside the altar. Prabhupada rushed inside and he found that the altar size was small. The deities of Jagannath were bigger and they were trying to push, you know, the deities inside. And Prabhupada was very unhappy, and then he told them to cut the top part, and then they took that top portion away, and Prabhupada came out fuming, angry. And as Prabhupada sat outside, he was asking, which rascal is responsible? Which rascal? What's going on here? And right behind Prabhupada, there was one hippie. He tapped Prabhupada on the back. Prabhupada turned back. The hippie gave Prabhupada one mala and said, don't be angry, chant Hare Krishna. So then Prabhupada said, you know, sometimes devotee is like an ocean. He is calm within, like the depths of the ocean, but sometimes on the surface there may be some storm. But that is just to actually train the devotees. So when Prabhupada would chastise, 20, 30, 40, 50 years later, people remember it, recall it as part of nectar and share it. But if you and me try that, it will be poison. It will not be nectar. So therefore, you know, the way certain exalted devotees can deal, we cannot deal in the same manner. We have to appreciate, recognize, acknowledge in the positive way. And even if people are making mistakes and we feel that these people need to be corrected, we cannot correct them in, you know, a whimsical manner. And so we have to really take care of this part of how to appreciate devotees. Another inherent need of the individual is status. What is my status in the association of devotees? So someone may say, hey, what is the status? Gopir Bhartur Padakamalayor Das Das Dasanu Das. That is your status. So recognition of one's standing and respect as per position. And so every devotee needs to feel a sense of contribution. That yes, you know, I am able to serve in this capacity, I am able to offer this service, I am able to make a difference in so and so way. So we have to recognize one's standing and give respect as per one's position. And this is extremely crucial in the association of devotees. When Hanumanji, he jumped over and went to meet Sita Devi. So at that point, Sita Devi glorified Hanumanji. And Hanumanji was glorified as the person who has done which no one can do. But Hanumanji was humble enough and he said that actually, mat vishishtata tulyascha santi tatra vanokasa matta pratyavara kaschit nasti sugriva sannidho. There is not a single monkey in the army of Sugriva who is not equal to me or better than me. In fact, I am simply a messenger. And if a messenger could do so much, you can imagine how much others can do. Aham tavat iha prapte kim punarte mahabala nahi prakrishta preshyante preshyante hi tarayana. So therefore, Hanumanji accepted the position as Rama Dutta, as a humble servant. He just took his position as insignificant. But we may have devotees who need a certain kind of understanding of what they are in the association of devotees. So they need to be respected as per their particular position. So it is described that if there is a speck of dust, that speck of dust, it has two choices. If that speck of dust comes in contact with air, that speck of dust can be picked up, and that speck of dust comes and places itself at the head of Krishna, on the turban of Krishna. And the same speck of dust, when it comes in contact with water, can be trampled by our feet. because it comes in contact with mud. So therefore, depending on the association, one's status changes. After millions of lifetimes a person has become a devotee, he must be recognized as a devotee and one must be respected for his position in his intention of trying to serve Krishna. That must be sincerely respected. And that's a very crucial thing. Prabhupada had one white suitcase, and one devotee wanted that white suitcase. It was a small white briefcase, and Prabhupada would keep his valuable stuff inside that. So this devotee could have been straightforward, but he thought, let me somehow get this Mahaprasad of the white suitcase. So he got a bigger suitcase and came to Srila Prabhupada and said, Srila Prabhupada, I want to give you this big suitcase. So he thought that Prabhupada will take the big suitcase and give him back the white suitcase. So Prabhupada took the big suitcase, opened it, put the small white suitcase inside and closed it. And Prabhupada picked both the suitcase together in his hand and looked in the mirror and said, how do I look? And then he did it a few times, and then Prabhupada said, you want that white suitcase? He said, yes. So Prabhupada said, be straightforward. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is Patita Pavan, not Kapata Pavan. And so it's very important that, just like in this particular scene when Mahaprabhu is embracing Sanatan Goswami, he tells Sanatan Goswami that you have to give up that chadar which you are wearing because it is not consistent with the kind of renunciation which you are trying to display. And therefore, when we come to the association of devotees, we are following certain principles, and those principles must be followed, adhered to, and we must respect all the devotees who are following those principles and offer that respect to the devotee, so that no devotee should feel that I am being disrespected in the association. So when Krishna, you know, that pastime will come later, we'll discuss that. Another inherent need of the individual is affiliation. Devotees need to feel that, okay, other devotees are my colleagues. I can share in confidence. There is a sense of camaraderie. I can delegate tasks to someone. I can actually feel someone is equal to me. I can experience friendship with others. And, trust, subordination, all of these are various needs connected to affiliation. So this is very crucial, because when we are in the association of devotees, all of us have various ways in which we express our Krishna consciousness. And that expression of Krishna consciousness may reflect through various devotees who are in the same mood. So therefore, Rupa Goswami says, Sa jati ashaye snigdhe sadhu sanga svatovare Srimat Bhagavat arthanam aswade rasikaisah. The Srimat Bhagavatam can be understood in the association of devotees when we have a similar mood with them. Sajati ashaye snigde, those of similar mood, sadhu sangha svatovare, who are better than us, more advanced than us. Parasparanu katanam pavanam bhagavat yasha mithaha rati mithaha tushti nivritta mitha atmana. When we discuss harikatha with each other, that is the process by which we actually bond with others through the kirtan, through the katha. And then it gives us a feeling that yes, we are all together, centered around the same cause. Yat shrinvato apaiti aratir vitrishna sattvam cha shuddhyati achirena pumsa bhaktim harau tat purushe cha sakhyam tadeva haram vadamanyase chit. Parikshit Maharaj describes, five effects of hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. He says, first, apaiti aratir vitrishna. The first thing by hearing is distaste for hearing goes away. Distaste for hearing goes away means we do not have automatic taste for hearing katha. And therefore it is not possible to study or hear for long periods of time. It takes a lot of effort to be able to connect with this message. Aratir. Only when you hear for a longer period of time, you will develop that taste. We were having yatra in Vrindavan, and you know, lecture was going on. And the lecture began at 9:30. And around 12:30, after 3 hours, we set up the prasadam stall in the back. And some sound started coming while we were setting up the prasadam. So some people looked behind and saw the prasadam is coming up. So they got inspired, started standing in line. Because it doesn't require any announcement for this. You know, and they were kind of standing, 100 of them. And at 12:30, Maharaj asked, shall I continue in the lecture? So everybody said, Hari Bol. And so these 100 people who were standing, very obvious that they are waiting for the lecture to end, they also raised their hand and said, Hari Bol. And then at 2:30, again he asked, shall I continue? And then again the lecture continued, and finally lecture ended at 3:30, 4 o'clock. So I saw these people who were standing from 12:30 onwards, waiting for lecture to be ending. So it is a fact that it is not easy to develop taste in hearing the Harikatha, and it takes a long practice to be able to connect. So Parikshit says, yat srinvato apaiti aratir. First, you hear sincerely, study sincerely, distaste will go away. Vitrishna, secondly, material desires will come down. Thirdly, sattvam cha shuddhyati, mode of goodness increases. Fourthly, bhaktim harau, devotion to Hari arises. Fifth, purushe cha sakhyam, one develops friendship towards devotees. So therefore, this is the fifth point which I was trying to share here. That camaraderie, friendship, trust develops when we hear and chant in the association of devotees. Purushe cha sakhyam tadeva haram vada manyaset chet. So therefore, you know, I was distributing the Gita in the local trains in Mumbai. And you know how crowded the local trains in Mumbai can be. If some of you have not experienced, you can try it sometime. One professor met me in America and he was telling me, what do you guys gain by traveling in those local trains? It's so crowded, it is so hellish. I was forced to travel one time and it was so bad. What do you guys get? I said, free massage. And so I entered into the train with book bag. And you know, I was against the wall of the train. And the book bag was hanging from my shoulder. One guy was pressed on my right hand, another guy was against my left hand, and I couldn't move. And someone came in front of me, his face right in front of me, looked at me and said, are you Hare Krishna? I said, who else dresses like this? Yes, we are Hare Krishna. So he said, can I have Gita? I said, take it from my bag. I can't move my hand, as you can see. So he put his hand inside the bag, picked the Gita. He said, how much? I said, 70 rupees. He put a 100 rupee note in front of me. I said, put it in my pocket, take 30 rupees change from my pocket. So he put that 100 rupees, took 30 rupees change. Whole Gita transaction happened without my moving. I realized I am not the doer. So when someone is in need, he comes searching for the Gita. And sometimes you are chasing somebody, take the Gita, and we'll see. Never changes. So therefore, the Bhagavad Gita is actually helping us connect with others, not at the level of our swadharma, not at the level of swabhava, but at the level of our swarupa. And that's what Arjuna got from Krishna, knowledge about his swarupa. So when here we refer to camaraderie or being a colleague or friendship and trust, this is not a sentimental thing. We are acknowledging the value of the decision which this soul has made to realize his eternal connection with Krishna. And therefore we respect that. And therefore we want to support this effort. And therefore this affiliation is extremely important. And so the sense of subordination is very important. Affiliation also means that if, suppose we are part of, we want to be affiliated to an ISKCON temple, then sometimes I may have to subordinate my desires. I may have to have the sense of subordination. Then I can be affiliated in that kind of a relationship. Like Prabhupada was in New Vrindavan, and Prabhupada was planning to make Haigriva Prabhu as the temple president. And he was not very happy with that idea. He heard rumors from others. So he wrote a whole few pages on why he is not qualified to be president. And put it in his pocket, came to meet Prabhupada. Offered obeisances and said, "Yes, Srila Prabhupada, how can I serve you?" He said that, but inside he knew, all these excuses are ready. Prabhupada looked at him coolly and said, "I agree, I want you to take sannyas." He said, "What?" "Yeah, I want you to take sannyas." He says, "Prabhupada, I just got married and I got a 2-year-old son. I cannot take sannyas." Prabhupada said, "No problem, you can take. Who will take care of my family?" "Krishna will take care." "But Prabhupada, it's not possible." And then he went on speaking for 15 minutes, how he cannot take sannyas, and finally concluded, "You tell me anything I will do, I cannot take sannyas." Prabhupada said, "Become president." So sometimes we may think, okay, everything can happen in friendship. We are all together. Let's all co-create a vision and do this, do that. Sometimes, the role of subordination is also important to be affiliated. Right? And Guru Kripa Prabhu, he was telling this story that he came back after preaching tour, collected a lot of money in Southeast. And he came to Vrindavan, and Prabhupada detected that he is feeling a sense of pride that this temple and everything is happening and Prabhupada is very much dependent upon me because I am bringing in the money and this and that. So he was sleeping at night. Prabhupada sent his servant to wake him up at 1 o'clock. So he woke up, saw the time, 1 o'clock. Prabhupada is calling at 1 o'clock, what's going on? He came to Prabhupada, offered obeisances. Prabhupada said, "Guru Kripa, what were you doing?" He said, "Prabhupada, I was sleeping." Prabhupada said, "Why were you sleeping?" He said, "Well, it's night time, so I'm sleeping." Prabhupada said, "It's night for me also, I'm not sleeping." He says, "Prabhupada, I'm tired after working all day." "I'm also tired, I also worked all day." He says, "Prabhupada, you are a pure devotee, I'm not a pure devotee." "Why you are not a pure devotee?" So he got bewildered. What does he want? So he understood something is wrong. He said, "Prabhupada, what should I do?" Prabhupada said, "Go back to sleep." So he got so bewildered. On the way back, he was thinking, maybe something is wrong with my attitude. So therefore, there is a difference between performing service and having the right service attitude. And therefore, the right service attitude means we are flexible to the desires and the demands made at different points, and we are willing to subordinate ourselves. And therefore, relationship is based on selfless devotion, respect and love. Kuchailam malinam kshamam dvijam dhamani santatam devi paryacharat sakshat chamara vyajanenavai. That Sudama was so poverty stricken when he came, Krishna sat at his feet and worshipped him. And on the way back, Sudama was thinking about how Krishna offered me respectful love. Shobhute Vishwabhavena Swasukhenabhi Vandita Jagama Swalayam Tata Patim Anuvrajjanandita. So in this verse, two particular words are specifically spoken. Vandita and Nandita. So Sudamaji specifically came to meet Krishna to get some wealth. Sudama did not give any wealth. He did not get any wealth. Krishna did not give him any wealth. But Krishna gave him respect and love. Therefore, the greatest gift we can give anybody is love and respect. And therefore, that satisfied Sudama completely. And that is what is described. Jagama swalayam tata pathim patham anuvrajya nandita. So therefore, he was perfectly peaceful and satisfied as he was going back. And therefore, he says, tasyaiva me sauhrda sakhya maitri. Dasyam punar janmani janmani syat mahanubhavena gunalayena vishajjatastat purusha prasanga. He says, my dear Lord, please give me sauhrda sakhya maitri of association of devotees. Already he saw, he got a big huge house and everything, but Sudama said, my dear Lord, I want the association, the friendship, the special grace and respect, a willingness for me to serve the devotees, an opportunity for me to offer respect to the devotees. And therefore, this Sudama's pastime is extremely crucial because it shows how one can actually capture the heart of other devotees. So in the association of devotees, if you want to actually manage ISKCON, then this is the only way where we actually show genuine love and respect to the Vaishnavas. Prabhupada's one disciple from Juhu, he was a pickpocket before Haridas Prabhu, and he saw the Prabhupada's photo with a golden wristwatch, and he felt attracted to steal that. And he came to Prabhupada, actually from the jail when he was released, he came to the ISKCON temple to meet Prabhupada for that. And then over a period of time, he became purified. And then he was in the kitchen cooking, and one day he found nobody has come. He asked Panchadravida Swami, why devotees have not come? So he said, well, Prabhupada is giving initiation today. So he went running. He told him, can I go and see initiations? He said, go and come back fast. So he came and standing in a corner, and he saw Prabhupada giving initiation. Prabhupada looked at him standing there. Prabhupada called him close. And Prabhupada asked him, do you want initiation? So this, you know, senior devotee was standing nearby. He whispered in Prabhupada's ear, Prabhupada is a pickpocket. He's a thief. Prabhupada said, I know what I am doing. Don't advise me. So Prabhupada turned to him and said, where are your beads? He said, I have not brought my beads. I come from the kitchen. Prabhupada took out his own beads from his mala and gave it to him and said, I give you the name Haridas. And then Prabhupada said, where did you come from? He said, kitchen. Go back, Prabhupada said. So he went back to the kitchen, and Panchadravida Swami was there in the kitchen. He said, where were you? You were away for such a long time. And he said, Prabhupada initiated me. He said, what? You just went from the kitchen to see the initiation ceremony and you come back initiated. How is it possible? And so Srila Prabhupada demonstrated so much of compassion, so much of mercy, and he was in the mood of being the servant. And because of being the servant, he could actually attract people's attention and hearts and serve them. And so relationships are based on sacrifice. So what is this pastime? This pastime represents conflict between which are the two personalities on the screen? There is a horse and there is this, Indra is on the top stealing the horse, and who is below? Prithu. King Prithu is performing how many horse sacrifices? 100 horse sacrifices, and Indra becomes insecure that I'm going to lose my position. So he steals, and then he starts wearing all kinds of upper sampradaya clothes, and Prithu starts attacking him. Now in one sense the mistake is Indra's. The mistake is Indra's. But Brahmaji appears and tells Prithu Maharaj, stop your 100th sacrifice. For you, 99 is sufficient. So now Prithu Maharaj could have reacted saying, hey, what is this? This is not fair. What is this going on? I don't agree with this. What mistake did I do? So Brahmaji gave him an offer. And the offer is basically valid for all of us. Which position are we interested in? Are we interested to sit on the throne of Swargaloka? Or we are interested to sit on the throne within Krishna's heart? Are we interested to enter the Swargaloka? Or we are interested to enter Krishna's heart? So if we are interested to enter and find a place in Krishna's heart, that happens when we are willing to sacrifice. When we are willing to sacrifice our opinions, sacrifice certain previously held positions, and submit and surrender to the Lord's desire. And therefore Prithu Maharaj becomes very famous. And he enters into the pages of Bhagavatam. Sudhiya sadhavo loke naradevo narottama nami druhyanti bhutebhya yarhinatma kalivaram. That's the glory of great souls. They are willing to sacrifice for the sake of pleasing Krishna. So when there is a difference of opinion going on, unless one of the devotees starts thinking in terms of sacrificing, the relationship is not going to work. And therefore, we find that Indra is an avatar, Prithu Maharaj is an avatar. This is a full-fledged conflict going on between two avatars. We should not inspire us that, oh, if avatars are also having conflict, so what is the problem with me? I can also have. No. This is to demonstrate that they are having conflict, but how they are resolving that conflict. So in the association of devotees, our goal is perfection, but the journey may be filled with imperfection. And so here we find that both Prithu and Indra are having their own periods of imperfection, and they are dealing with that accordingly. And therefore, this kind of sacrifice is extremely important. So we find that one time Nakul and Sahadev, so amongst them Sahadev is the famous astrologer. So Duryodhan comes to Sahadev and says that you are an astrologer, can you give a specific formula by which the Kauravas can be victorious? Some yajna, some puja. So Sahadev, being very simple minded, he says, okay, there is this Kalabali Yajna which you can do on Amavasya day. And whoever does Kalabali on Amavasya will become victorious. So Duryodhan is very happy. He says, thank you for giving me that secret. And so Duryodhan starts preparing for Kalabali Yajna, which is next day is Amavasya. Amavasya is new moon night. So now Krishna is in anxiety. Because Krishna has taken a vow that I will protect my devotees. So Krishna thinks that how many times these Pandavas will really goof up? How many times I'm going to protect them? And so Krishna immediately calls the Brahmanas together one day before Amavas and starts doing puja for worshipping the forefathers. It is called Pitri Tarpan. So as he is worshipping the forefathers, the pujaris and the Brahmins are also bewildered that this is done usually on Amavas only, on new moon night. Why Krishna is doing one day before? So they are confused. But more confused are in the sky Surya and Chandra. So Surya asks Chandra, when is Amavasya? So Chandra says, as per my calculation, it is tomorrow. Why is he doing today? Maybe he is mistaken. Let us go and advise him. So both Surya and Chandra come down. They call the Lord to the side and said, my dear Lord, there is a little discrepancy. Krishna says, what happened? You are doing this Pitri Tarpan today. Amavas is tomorrow. Why you are doing today? Krishna says, Amavas, new moon is when sun and moon are in straight line. Right now you are standing in straight line in front of me. Amavas is today. So Krishna changes whole Amavas definition. And then Krishna calls the Pandavas and makes them do the Kalabali Yajna one day before. Next day Duryodhana is doing as per Panchang. He doesn't know, things have already changed. So therefore, Sarathya Parashada Sevana Sakhyadauta Virasananu Stavana Stavana Pranaman Snigdheshu Pandushu Jagat Pranatim Cha Vishnum Bhaktim Karoti Nripatish Charanaravindi. That Pandavas were Snigdheshu. Snigdheshu means in Sanskrit Sneha. You must have heard the word Sneha means affection. So Snigdha comes from Sneha. Sneha means ghee. Sneha technically means ghee. And ghee has the quality of burning itself and giving light in return. So the whole idea of sacrifice means that yes, we have to burn some of our opinions, some of our desires, some of our priorities in respect, with respect to someone else's desire. And that's how the relationship can be maintained. And therefore, only with endless capacity to forgive and sacrifice, a relationship can be maintained for long periods. And so the relationship of trust. And there was a forest fire which attacked Krishna, and Krishna drank that forest fire. And that forest fire, according to Bhaktivinoda Thakur, represents discord and disunity and lack of trust amongst the devotees. Like that. And I share this story often, and you know, from the Ramayana. Ram and Lakshman are in the forest along with Sita Devi at Guha's place. And Ram and Sita are sleeping on the grass. So Lakshman stands with his, you know, sword in his hand and starts circumambulating Sita and Ram. So Guha looks at Lakshman and says, why don't you go to sleep? Lakshman says, how can I sleep when the goddess of fortune and the husband of the goddess of fortune are on the floor? I have taken a vow that for the next 14 years till Lord Ram comes back and sleeps in his royal bed, I will not sleep. I have given up sleep. And Lakshman continues circumambulating Sita and Ram who are sleeping. Lakshman has a sword in his hand. Guha develops doubt. Guha starts thinking, the reason Lakshman is circumambulating with sword in his hand is he wants to become king of Ayodhya. He is an agent of Bharat, and at night he will kill Ram and help Bharat become the king. Who told him? Nobody. His mind. So therefore, eternal suspicion. So now Guha is circumambulating with arrow in his hand and a bow behind the trees with his arrow pointed at Lakshman. And Guha says, Jai Sri Ram. I will not allow Ram to be destroyed like this by Lakshman. My seva is to protect Ram. Who gave him seva? Nobody. He took it upon himself. So Sita and Ram sleeping, Lakshman circumambulating. Behind him, Guha is circumambulating from behind the trees with his arrow pointed at Lakshman. Now Guha's soldiers look at this scene and they start discussing, what is this Guha doing? Someone says he is not satisfied just being king of the forest. He wants to become king of Ayodhya, looks like. So another says, see, his arrows are pointed to Ram. Now the arrows were not pointed at Ram. The arrows were pointed at Lakshman. And then another soldier says, I am a devotee of Ram. I will not allow Guha to kill Ram like this. This is not fair. And all of them say, okay, let us all take a vow to destroy Guha if he tries to do anything like this. So all of them take their arrows and start circumambulating Guha with arrows pointed at Guha. So that night in the forest, only two people are sleeping peacefully, Sita and Ram. All the others are in anxiety. That is called mutual suspicion. Okay, so we talk about relationship of trust. What all of them had in common? They were totally dedicated in their devotion to Ram. So if you had asked any of them, what is your mission in life? Jai Sri Ram. So they had full conviction and faith and trust in Ram. They had total distrust in Ram Sevaks. So it is a scenario which can happen in the association of devotees. And so we have to be extremely careful about this. And so the disintegration of Gaudiya Math is an example where the ray of Vishnu, who is one of the Manjaris from the spiritual world, could not prevent a fratricidal warfare amongst powerful scholars and devotees. And the court case in the Gaudiya Math began in 1948, continues even till date. So therefore, we have to be extremely careful about being offensive and respectful. So we should not be offensive. We should try to be respectful towards each other. And that's a very crucial instruction. And dealings within the society, either with seniors, with equals and with juniors, has to be done with proper understanding and respect. In fact, Srila Prabhupada was very, very respectful even to those who were not fully practicing Krishna consciousness but were helpful to ISKCON. And so Srila Prabhupada created Sri Sri Radha Ras Bihari Committee, and His Holiness Giriraj Maharaj and various other pioneer devotees in Juhu, they were regularly cultivating such well-wishers. So Prabhupada was on the terrace in Juhu land, and one of the Birla's relatives, Mr. Brij Ratan Mohata, entered and offered obeisances. And Prabhupada was talking to a group of well-wishers, and Prabhupada turned to Mr. Mohata and introduced him to others and said, this is Mr. Mohata. He's a very big businessman. So Mr. Mohata immediately said to Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada, you went to America with 40 rupees, now you have a property worth 400 million rupees. You are the real businessman. Prabhupada said to him, why don't you join my business then? So he said, well, I'm not ready, but at least I can support from outside. And so Srila Prabhupada gave him the service of actually managing the contractors, managing the construction. And he told the devotees that this is their regular skill, let them do that, because we should conserve our energy for preaching of the holy names and practicing the process. And so Srila Prabhupada was very expert in dealings with all categories of people. With seniors, one must be in the mood of service and submissive inquiry. With equals, friendship, cooperation, service. With juniors, mercy and enlightenment. And therefore, there are three methods of offering and receiving correction. The right attitude is, correction isn't synonymous with finding fault or becoming angry. Focusing more on the service side of the devotees by tolerating shortcomings. No one comes perfect. Okay, so you should not just be concerned with correcting just for the sake of it. You should focus more on the service while tolerating the shortcomings. I was sharing this story. Kaushalya Devi, she was so instrumental in establishing ISKCON in Jaipur. She organized a pandal program. And there was this Indian businessman who was sitting there and he started finding fault, saying that Prabhupada ji, this Western devotees, they don't know any philosophy, they know kirtan and all that. Prabhupada became very angry. And Prabhupada said, what do you mean? This girl here, she's very scholarly. She knows all the Upanishads. And that devotee knew only 5 verses of Ishopanishad. Prabhupada turned to her and said, recite all the Upanishads. And she was nervous. She started chanting the first verse, second verse, third verse. And she was thinking when she came to the fourth verse, now I will be exposed. As soon as she chanted the fifth verse, Prabhupada said, bas, that means you know everything. So immediately, this Indian gentleman was sitting. He said, Swamiji, but her pronunciation of Sanskrit was not proper. Prabhupada said, but her renunciation is great. She has renounced so much in the service of Krishna. Why don't you appreciate that? So therefore, we have to focus more on the service side of the devotees while tolerating shortcomings. So we should not be looking at faults, but we should know that we are all here to get treated in the hospital. We are in the process of getting transformed gradually. Second is right authority. One should follow oneself before asking others. Spiritual authority is established based on love and trust. And therefore, managerial authority should consider the domain of one's influence. So these are the three types of authority: ethical authority, spiritual authority, and managerial authority. And so, while we are offering and receiving correction, we should be very sensitive if we have the appropriate authority for following any of this. And the right action is tactful and friendly demeanor. Forgive the wrongdoer, allow them to start afresh. Prevention is better than cure. Place systems to check deviations. Very beautiful point. And therefore, 4 suggestions are there to deal with Vaishnava Aparad. Adjust misunderstandings on the basis of common connection to Krishna. Yes, we are all connected and related to Krishna. Let us adjust. Be humble enough to beg forgiveness immediately and earnestly. Hold oneself accountable even for offense committed by one's subordinates and beg forgiveness. Okay. And therefore, one should try to understand that yes, there is no harm in begging forgiveness. And clarify the situation by proper communication. So it's very important to have good communication, and based on good communication only, we can actually establish the trust in the association of devotees. And so therefore, you know, the 4th aspect is seva or care. And how can care be implemented? You know, in the traditional way was through varnashrama, but now we need an ecosystem of care and the ecosystem of care has to be established in the form of either some kind of devotee care system where devotees feel cared for, counselor system or mentor system or Maitri system or whatever. When the devotees experience care, then all the other three things of sadhana, sadachar and sambandha, all of those make sense and they really feel I must connect and do something substantial. And therefore the devotees feel that I need to reciprocate and actually help in this mission of Srila Prabhupada. And therefore, you know, the culmination of all the other three is in the society of devotees prioritizing care so that this ecosystem of care inspires every person to engage in Krishna's seva. He really wants to actually serve from the core of his heart, from the bottom of his heart. And that's basically the whole idea of understanding the concept of devotee care. And so in our, you know, system in Mumbai, it took a long time before the counselor system could be established. We went through lots of struggles, and initially everybody just wanted to come to few senior people only and get counseled. But then as the numbers grow, it becomes difficult to take care of more than 15-20 people. And so how can a system be implemented where every devotee has some shelter, some place where he can go and actually experience physical, emotional, social and spiritual care? And that basically is the foundation for the principle of seva. And as all of us know, although we have taken to the vows of Krishna consciousness, things will not always happen the way we expect. There will be ups and downs, difficulties, challenges. Then we are shaken. That time we need the shelter of devotees even more than any other time. Like I was traveling in a flight from Venice to Belgium, and our flight got cancelled repeatedly, once, twice, thrice. And the last time it got cancelled, they said, all your check-in luggage you go and take. And then there is one more flight for which we are offering tickets. Whoever reaches first at the counter will get, you know, first X number of tickets. So I told my colleagues, you go and get the bags. I will go and stand in the line, because nobody will think of this idea. You know, this is a typical Indian style idea that, okay, we work it out like that. So they went to get the bags. I went and stood in the queue and there was nobody. I was the first person. And I was very proud of my idea that, oh, wow, what a brilliant idea that I could come here right in the front. So I was the first one to get the ticket. And I looked back and saw the long line and I was thinking, such a simple idea, they couldn't get it. And then when it was time for getting the boarding pass, I took the ticket and went to the boarding pass counter. The lady looked at it and said, sorry sir, it is tomorrow's ticket which has been issued for you. I was stuck with disbelief. I said, no, I was the first in the line. He said, no, but it is tomorrow's ticket. I saw it was tomorrow's ticket. I went back to that counter and told the lady, hey, I was standing first in the line. You gave me tomorrow's ticket. She looked and said, oh, sorry, I had a sleepless night. I made a mistake. And I just couldn't believe it that I was first in the line. I got the ticket first, but not that day's, next day's. What a disaster. And I was becoming angry. And she looked at me and looked at my bead bag and said, why don't you chant on your beads and become peaceful? You know, so I just took the beads and she said, oh, last three, if three passengers drop out, you may get. So we were three of us. And next half an hour, I was chanting like I've never chanted before. And then we actually got the, you know, three standby tickets. So when your plans fail and things don't work out, you become agitated. And when we become agitated, we need support. And so many devotees have left Krishna consciousness movement because something happened in their life, but there was no one they could take shelter of. There was no one who could care for them. There was no one whom they could actually connect and express their problems and get some tangible solutions. So therefore, it's very important that for ISKCON society to grow forward, we need to prioritize devotee care. And I'm sure each one of you in your own life have personal experiences of this. And that's the whole principle of today's presentation, that yes, the foundational pillar of our movement is Braja Bhakti. To experience that, we need to begin with sadhana. That sadhana we can actually improve upon and absorb ourselves by having the right sadachar. By pleasing the devotees, we get the blessings of the devotees. And when the devotees bless us, we develop humility and tolerance to be able to have good sambandha relationships with other devotees. When our relationships with other devotees become congenial, then we are in a position to offer proper seva. And so seva doesn't mean just doing things. Seva actually means offering service to Krishna and offering service to the Vaishnavas. And offering service to the Vaishnavas includes offering care for the Vaishnavas. So I'm very happy that here in South Africa, all of you are really trying to push on the Krishna consciousness movement very sincerely, very seriously. And I'm very impressed to see the efforts made by all of you in bringing Krishna consciousness in such difficult conditions. I hope and pray that you continue your efforts in your own personal lives, understand Srila Prabhupada's books. Those books are there in most of your houses. Open them, study them. They are available to read for free. You have paid for them. So, I mean, you don't even have to go to your bookshelves. Now all of the books are in your cell phones. You just have to go into your phones and read those books. Understand the literatures. Connect in your own lives. Transform your lives. Experience the transformation yourselves. That is the greatest cause of conviction. And with that conviction, you will be able to share that conviction with others. That is substantial preaching, which will be impactful. It will transform you. It will transform others. And then society will be transformed, which is what Srila Prabhupada aspired for, as far as Krishna consciousness movement is concerned. Thank you all very much. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. I'm sure you all agree that was a very enlightening workshop. And we're very pleased to have been here with Gauranga Prabhu today. So to show our appreciation and gratitude for him, let us all loudly chant, Hari Bol! Hari Bol! Prabhu, thank you very much. We're very blessed to have your association.
Thank you.
We'd like to thank NJP and Prabhana Prabhu and his team. Oh, are there any questions before we go to closing up? Does anybody want to ask any questions?
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much, Prabhu, for your wonderful presentation. And even on a personal interaction, your very pleasant demeanor. Thank you. I have a question when we're speaking about sacrifice and subordination. Sometimes when you're dealing with devotees in any leadership position, we may detect that the instruction or the manner in which they're dealing is illogical, based on misinformation, even based sometimes on a false ego platform. lack of information, etc. So how do we react to that? Do we sacrifice and subordinate? Because sometimes it's the sanctity of ISKCON that is at stake, rather than just, you know, your own subordination.
Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was very forgiving to Jagai and Madhai, but he was very strict with Kal Krishnadas. So Kal Krishnadas was kidnapped by the Bhattaharis in the south. And when Mahaprabhu came back, he said, I can't keep him with me anymore. Why? Because the position of being Mahaprabhu's personal servant was a very high profile, very important position. And the behavior shown by Kal Krishnadas was not consistent with maintaining that position. So Mahaprabhu had to move him on. But of course, the community of devotees, they responded with great responsibility. They did not abandon Kal Krishnadas. Nityananda, Jagadananda, Mukunda, Damodar, Charijana, Yuktikare, Karilo Antar. These four devotees came together and said, oh, now Kal Krishnadas has been abandoned by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. But the Vaishnava Sangha cannot abandon. So let us offer shelter. So one thing is that sometimes, because of institutional reasons, someone may be disciplined at one level. But rather than understanding the mood of Chaitanya Charitamrita, when someone is disciplined at one level, sometimes people feel everybody should discipline him. And there is no one who actually offers shelter and care to that person. So therefore, at some level, someone may be subjected to discipline, but still there are others who can offer shelter and care. So that kind of maturity must be there in the association of devotees, because durapahi alpatapasa seva vaikuntha vartmasu yatropa giyate nityam deva devo janardana. After millions and millions of lifetimes, a soul actually comes to the satsanga. So therefore, even while instituting discipline, we should have the maturity and the understanding of how Mahaprabhu and Acharyas dealt with various situations and deal appropriately. Okay, so disciplinary action does not mean abandonment by the Vaishnava Sangha from the association. It does not mean that, you know, one has absolutely nothing. So it all depends. Sometimes in certain cases, certain rulings may be there. It's a different case. But in general, at a social level, people start withdrawing. And then when a person feels that he is completely alone, then he loses the taste for being in that satsanga. So in my experience, what I have found is, you know, the association of devotees can be like a double-edged sword. You know, it's very intimate, very nice, very attractive. But then sometimes, when something goes wrong, you know, not everybody is trained to appropriately react and respond. And sometimes devotees feel that it's too embarrassing for me to stay in this association anymore. And then they withdraw themselves completely. So we need to have that kind of maturity and understanding to know how to appropriately deal in different situations. There is no black and white, you know, as such. It's easier to deal with outside people that way. You know, we had South India Yatra, and we had set up our pandal, prasadam, and commissioner of police came in with his van, police van. And he said, what permission you have taken? I'm going to close this down and this and that and everything. I said, well, we have made some moong dal paisam, please take it. So he said, hey, why, you are trying to bribe me or what? So I said, no, I'm just giving you prasad, take it. So he took you know, one bowl of prasad. Then he turned to me and said, can I have one more? So we gave him one more. He had two, three, five he finished. So he went inside the car and brought out his stainless steel dabba. And he said, can you fill me this also? And then we filled that also. Then he said, well, you know, next time you should inform me and communicate me whenever you're doing such kind of things is not good. Okay, but anyway, prasad was really good. So it was like, he was angry with something, but still, he was just satisfied with prasad. But once you are in the association of devotees, one requires tremendous degree of sensitivity and maturity. And so when Vasudeva was dealing with Nanda Maharaj, prajashaya nivrittasya prajatat samapadyata, Vasudeva tells Nanda Maharaj, oh, at such an advanced age, you got a praja. He is not saying you got a son or you got a daughter. Why? Because he knows that actually it was a daughter born and I replaced with a son. So Vasudeva is very careful. I should not speak even half truth and get away with it because it will be an offense. So I know it was a daughter born, so I cannot ask Nanda Maharaj, how come after a long time you got a son? That would be a false statement because Vasudeva knows it was a daughter. So he doesn't use the word son, he doesn't use the word daughter, he uses the word praja. Praja means progeny. So he's being very, very careful how he's dealing in that kind of situation. So therefore, Chanakya Pandit says that depending on the level which we have to protect, we have to appropriately deal with the lower levels of sacrifice. To protect the individual sometimes, up to protect the town, individual, or to protect a family sometimes an individual may be sacrificed. To protect a village, a family may be sacrificed. To protect a country, a village may be sacrificed. And to protect the soul, whole world may be sacrificed. So that is Chanakya Pandit's statement. But it has to be applied with a lot of maturity and thought. So that's my response to your question. Any other? Any other question? Yeah.
Firstly, thank you very much for your association and also welcome to South Africa.
Thank you.
And I hope you'll come again. Just threading from the question and your answer, you know, when you, in your preamble, you spoke about the process that was given to us, and it's an individual responsibility of how we're actually going to apply this process. And I can remember His Holiness Bhakti Tritaswami Maharaj always using this example that if you squeeze an orange, you're not going to get anything else but orange juice from it. So that's just more like kind of a comment. And the other thing is the letters that you used. Did you take them from the Bhaktivedanta database?
Yeah.
Okay, thank you. Thank you once again.
Thank you, Matt. So what, we'll do a 5 minutes kirtan and then after you make your announcement. The mridanga player.
So we'd just like to thank Gauranga Prabhu again for this wonderful opportunity that he's giving us. And as a small token of our appreciation to you, Prabhana Prabhu has a, well, from all of us actually, to show our appreciation to you, we've got a little something to offer you.
Oh, Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.
Thank you to all of you for being here and making the effort to be here. I'm sure you've all benefited in some way or the other, and we're all going to work together now to build a stronger community and society. I'd like to thank Prabhupada Prabhu and his team, Srinivas Acharya Prabhu, Raghunath Prabhu, Achyutananda Prabhu, Kishore Prabhu, Ashim Krishna Prabhu, Shyamarani Mataji, and all the many other devotees who kindly assisted in setting up this function and hosting us so graciously. Most importantly, I'd like to thank Srila Prabhupada for the mercy that he's showing us and for this wonderful society that he's given us to help us find our way back home. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. Krishna, Krishna, Hare, Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Prabhupada, Prabhupada,
Prabhupada, Prabhupada. Nitai Bhav, Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav. Nitai Gaur Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav. Jai Jai Jagannath, Jagannath, Baladev, Jai Subhadra. Jai Jai Jagannath, Jagannath, Baladev, Subhadra. Nitai Gaur Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav, Hari Bhav, Gaur Hari Bhav.
Jai Hari Nam Sankirtan Ki, Srila Prabhupada Ki, Samasta Gaur Bhakta Vrinda Ki, Nitai Gaur Premanande. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to assembled devotees. All glories to Sri Guru and Sri Gauranga.